Te digo de mi parte que no aguanto más. Ya no aguanto ver el otro como dice.
Hey YouTube, your girl is back. It's been a while and I miss you all too. Okay, this time I'm going to show you the difference between knot braids and knotless braids. Also, I've seen people call box braids knotless braids, which I can say is not the same. I will get to that later. Before we get started, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, kindly do so and turn on post notifications so you do not miss whenever I post. Also, share this link with your friends and family. Thank you. How do I start this? Okay, so you can have box knotless braids or box knot braids, just like you can have triangle knotless or triangle knot braids. Box or triangle is basically how you cut or part the hair into. So basically, one, knot braids comes with a knot at the base or root of your hair. Two, it's sometimes painful depending on your stylist or hair braider. Three, it comes out full and takes a lot of wig. Four, it's somehow a protective style, meaning that you might lose your hair after unbraiding, also depending on your stylist. Five, but it doesn't take much time. Here I have a client with permed hair who wants a box knot braid. If you look, you see a knot at the base. I'm halfway done, but looking at it, it's full already. Like I said earlier, it comes out heavy and you can't move the braids around easily, especially the first few days. I part the hair in a box. Pay attention to this method. When wrapping it around, I twist it so I can have the knot neat and also the knot doesn't come out too big or rough. Then I'm done. I trim, put it in hot water, mousse, wrap it, and my client is good to go. You know I don't play with my mousse foam wrap.
Dressing and flexing. You have been posting and liking. Posting and liking. Commenting. Commenting. I did live my life away. You just despise. Back. Back. Back.
Back. Back. Now, let's move to knotless braids. 1. Knotless braids is a protective style for both natural hair and permed or relaxed hair. That is if you unbraid it right, of course. 2. It doesn't come with a knot. Hashtag knot free. 3. It's almost pain free. You feel very little pain. 4. It doesn't take much wig or extensions. You can use at least 2 packs of wig, depending on the length and the volume you want. 5. It doesn't come out full or heavy, meaning it's easy to handle. 6. It takes a lot of time to have it done, which I think is totally worth it because of the fact that it's pain-free and also a very good protective style.
Since me youngin, living and learning, dressing and flexing.
Here I'm about braiding a knotless box braid on natural hair, which I'm not going to blow dry like most stylists do because it makes their work easier, but not healthy for the client's hair. Remember, at Tanto Styles, we really care about our client's hair and we do what is best for the client. So, if you see here, I have it part in box and the braids are knotless. I start braiding her hair, then I add the wig at least 3 or 4 times, depending on the size you want. Meaning, it's pain-free. You can move and hold it the minute you're done without feeling anything. How cool is that? See why I will go for Knotless? And when I'm done braiding, I put it in hot water, mousse it. And my client is ready to go. I hope you know the difference between knot braids and knotless braids now. You know which braid style to go for. Let me know if you want more videos like this in the comments below. Remember, with Tantal Styles, I don't only braid, I care for hair. Kindly subscribe to my channel for more posts like this and like, leave a comment below. If this video is helpful, share with friends. Don't be stingy. It's your girl, Tantal Styles. Bye. She knows she the baddest. Turn over, 10 she knows.